Well, we've spoke to the police about a number of issues pertaining to how to deliver counter-radicalisation strategy, but one of the things that came across most strikingly for me was the amount of work they have to do on safe giving and working with the Charity Commission and across local partnerships, because there really is quite a worrying level of intimidation and, for want of a better word, I would say religious extortion. It appears that fundraisers from both registered and unregistered charities are targeting Muslim communities because of their religious injunction to give to charity. And of course, there is the worry, not only of the damage that this does to Muslim communities who feel put upon, but also where this money goes, whether that is for criminal means or possibly even for terrorism.
What kind of things are actually happening?
Well, one instance that I was told about was to repeatedly press the red button at a traffic light and block all of the cars down the road and then go down with buckets. So really you have a captive audience there, and people feel really like they have to give.
Are we looking perhaps at criminal gangs, or is there proof that some of this money is actually going to fund terrorism?
At the moment, these are just concerns. No one is really sure where the money is going, but that is in of itself a huge problem. Some of the intimidation techniques are, I understand, done by registered charities. So in the most cases, we do know that that money is going to the purposes that it's supposed to humanitarian aid, for example. But it's the unregistered charities where we simply have no idea where this money is going. And because they're not, there's no regulatory body account that they're accountable to, the Charity Commission, the local authorities, they're not responsible for where this money is going. So in those cases, there really is a worry about where the money's ending up.
What would you like to see happen then?
I mean, I think the police are doing very good work in West Yorkshire, trying to establish relationships with communities, with partner organisations to encourage safe giving so that people feel that they can say no. But that's the softer end. I think at the more targeted end of this, there perhaps needs to be more investigations into these unregistered charities and possibly an extra duty on the Charity Commission or on local authorities to some sort of regulation of unregistered charities, I think would be helpful.
OK, Hannah Stuart, we've got to leave it there. Thanks very much indeed for joining us.